Hello children, we will do a chapter from your English paper 1 syllabus, that is the second chapter from your syllabus, The Memoirs of Marco Polo. This is the story about Marco Polo, who was a Venetian traveler, that is a person who had come all the way from Venice to the eastern part of the world, and he had written down his experiences, what he had seen in the eastern part of the world to the people living in the west. We will learn about a time when there was no such means of communication, was not as developed as it is now. And how he had come all the way from Venice, from Italy to China, and what he had seen, what were his experiences, that we will learn today. So the chapter begins with Marco Polo. He is writing, it is like an autobiography. The story is, he is saying the story, or he is sharing his experiences in his own words. And this Memoirs of Marco Polo, this is written by an anonymous author. That is, we don't know the name of the author who had written this. Marco Polo, he is saying that he was born in the beautiful city of Venice, which is in Italy. It was one of the most prosperous and prominent centers of trade in the region around the Mediterranean Sea in the 13th century. So we are reading about a time that is the 13th century. During this time, Venice, which is a very beautiful city, even now it is located in Italy, and during that time, Venice was a very important center of trade in the Mediterranean region. It is a city which is located near the Mediterranean Sea, and all the places that are located near the Mediterranean Sea, among all the places, it was a very well-known, prominent means well-known, prosperous, that is developed center of trade. That is, merchants from all over the places, they used to come to Venice for buying and selling of their goods. So he was born there in the 13th century. His father Niccolo and his uncle Maffeo had set out on their travels far and wide when I was very little, and 7 years passed before they returned. Marco Polo is saying that his father's name was Niccolo and his uncle was Maffeo, and these, his father and uncle, they would set out for long journeys. I have told you that we are reading about a time when the communication system was not so developed, that is, it took a lot of time for the people to go from one place to another. And when Marco Polo's uncle or father, they would travel, it would take them years to come back to the to their home. So Marco Polo is saying that I was very little, and 7 years passed before they returned, and he was very little when his uncle and brother father, they had set out on a journey. And when he could remember, his first distinct, that is, his first clear memory of his father was when he was in his teens, that is, when he had already grown up. So when he was very little, his father and uncle, they had gone on a voyage, that is, on a long journey. And when they returned, and by the time they returned home, returned to Venice, Marco Polo was a grown-up boy. So he is saying that he did not have a very clear memory of his father when he was very little. Then he is saying, in the meanwhile, my mother passed away and I was raised by my aunt and uncle. I was trained to be a merchant so that I would carry on the family trade. Besides reading, writing and arithmetic, I learned how to use foreign currency, judge the value of goods before buying or selling them, and deal with cargo ships. Marco Polo is saying that when his father was away, during that time his mother passed away, his mother died, and he was looked after, he was raised by, he was brought up by his uncle and aunt. And when he was growing up, he was given a training to be a merchant, because his father and his uncle both were merchants, they were involved in trade, and so he was also given the same training. And what was the training? That he learned how to read, write, and to do the simple calculations or arithmetic. This he had learned. Along with that, he was given special training so that he could become a merchant. And what were his special trainings? That is, he was given the training to learn how to use the foreign currency. That is, the money that was used in different regions of the world, in different parts of the world. He needed to know this because otherwise how people buy or sell the goods along. So first he learned how to use the foreign currency. Second, he learned to judge the value of goods before buying or selling them. If he was buying a good or if he was selling them, he need to know the value of it, whether what will be the worth of it or not, whether it is a good, whether the thing is proper or not, he needs to learn that. So he was given training in that also. Along with that, he had also learned how to deal with cargo ships. What are cargo ships? That is the ships that are mainly used for carrying goods from one place to another. So he had to learn how to handle or how to manage these things also. So apart from reading, writing and doing calculations or arithmetic, he was also given training in these things so that he could become a merchant when he grew up. Then he is saying that his father and uncle, they returned from China. They had gone to China and they had returned from there where they had met the ruler Kublai Khan. The ruler of China during that time was Kublai Khan. His uncle and his father, they met Kublai Khan, and when they came back to Venice, they brought some letters written by Kublai Khan, and these letters were written to the Pope. Who is the Pope? The Pope is the head of the Christian religion, and the Pope was there in Italy. So these letters he had brought, his father and uncle had brought from Kublai Khan, and they were supposed to give these letters to the Pope. And Kublai Khan, he is a Marco Polo thing. He had learned from his father that Kublai Khan was very much interested in knowing about the Christian religion. He had heard about it from the merchants, from his Marco Polo's father and uncle, and he was very keen. He was very interested in knowing more about this religion, and he was also interested in importing this Christianity or teaching the people of China how to follow this religion. So he had written the letters to the Pope. So in this first page that we have done today, it is telling us about Marco Polo's childhood, and he is saying that he was born in the Venice in the 13th century. His father and uncle, they were both merchants, and so when he was grown up, it would take them years to come back or to return from a place. So Marco Polo did not have any very clear memory of his father when he was young, little, but when the first clear memory of his father was when he had already grown up. He was also given training to be a merchant, and his father and uncle, they had gone all the way from Venice to China for the purpose of trading, that is for buying or selling of goods. And we know that China is in the eastern part of the world, so they had come from Europe. Italy is in Europe, from there to China, and in China they met Kublai Khan, who was very interested in knowing more about Christianity and teaching the people of his kingdom the Christian religion. And he had also written letters which his father and uncle brought all the way from China. So today we have done the first page of this chapter, and you have learned some new words, like the meaning of the words are given, like prominent, which means well known. You have learned the meaning of the word distinct, which means a very clear memory, and cargo ships, keen on and imparting. These are the new words that you have learned. The meanings are given at the end of the page. After reading the page, you have to learn the meanings. So for today, we are keeping up to this much. We have learned up to that Kublai Khan was interested in importing Christianity to his countrymen. In our next video, we will take up the next portion of the chapter. Thank you.